Hey my sweet pen friends, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Devin, and in today's video, I wanted to share with you a few more stationery items that I've decided to break up with. You may remember at the beginning of this year, I posted a stationery declutter, and if you haven't seen that video, I'll have it linked in the cards and in the description box below. While I did already go through the whole decluttering process, I feel like it's important to continuously check in, and I think this will be an ongoing assessment just to make sure that the things that are in my space are things that I love and enjoy using. Oh, I feel like I'm gonna break a lot of hearts with this one, and this is probably a good time to say that these are my own opinions, and if you happen to love some of the items that I'm sharing today, I don't mean any offense. I'm not here to change your mind about those things. I would say at one point or another, these things brought me a lot of joy, but over time, it's lost a little bit of its luster. So just wanted to put that disclaimer out there. This item is a fountain pen, and already I know that's probably like got you on the edge of your seat, does it not? I mean, it does kind of for me, even though I already know what it is. It's the Twisby Diamond 580 ALR in purple. This is an interesting situation for me because when this first came out, I was pretty excited about it. I was in it. I was on the bandwagon. I was excited, but I did hold off on purchasing it, and that might be due to the fact that I was still pretty new to the fountain pen hobby. I guess not as new. I don't know. I still feel pretty new to the hobby, but there's just something that was telling me you can wait. You can wait on it. And eventually an opportunity presented itself when I was browsing Goulet pens, and I saw on their bottom shelf link that they had this at a discounted price. And that section of their website is essentially just items that have been returned that are still in good condition, or perhaps they have something that's going on with it that happened during transit, but all of it is still usable and ready to be enjoyed. So I decided that that was it. That was the sign that I needed to go ahead and purchase this pen, and I did. And now that I've spent some time with it, I just feel like it's not the right pen for me. I will say that this is a great pen. The 580, awesome. I have one. I actually really enjoy. This is one of my favorite pens. This is the Twisby Diamond 580 RG2. The grip section on this purple one does have that ribbed feature that I know is kind of polarizing for a lot of people. And this is also in a broad nib where the RG2 is in an extra fine. So when I think about those things, I'm really trying to discern what it is that I just don't jive with the ALR purple. And I think I thought it was the color, but I'm looking at it now and I really like the color. So I think it's the broad nib. I don't know, maybe I'm just not a broad nib baby, you know? I feel like I would be open to trying another broad nib, perhaps in a different pen, because I want to be able to like have a little bit of variety in my fountain pen collection. This was the only broad nib fountain pen that I had. But I think it's time to just say goodbye. Like, there's definitely a difference to me when I hold these pens. I'm excited to use the rose gold, and perhaps because it's rose gold and it just is a stunning pen. But this is also a stunning pen, you know? I don't know. I feel differently, and I think I'm ready to say goodbye to it. If you've been following along my channel for a while, this might be a little surprising, or maybe not. I feel like there might have been a video where I mentioned how I felt, but in this video, I'm definitely gonna talk about how I feel, and that is the fact that I am ready to break up with the Design Works ink notebooks. I did talk about these notebooks in my best notebooks for note-taking, and if you haven't seen that video, I'll have it linked in the cards and in the description box below. And while I still believe that these are great notebooks for note-taking as well as giving it as gifts, I just have kind of grown out of this stage. I mean, I would hunt these notebooks down around whenever I went to Target or Barnes & Noble or TJ Maxx. I was always excited to see the different covers that they came out with. I feel like the styles are really appealing and aesthetic. I do still very much like the page format. They have a lot of different ones where they have the perpetual calendar at the top, or like this one, it's just a simple subject and date. I like all of the things that they include in this notebook. But for me, it really has come down to the paper quality, and fountain pens have really forced me to change my perspective on paper. At first, I thought it was just all about the pens, and if it was a good pen, then you could make it work on any paper. But I have come to realize, and this is a culmination of experience over the past year or so, that paper really does matter. Great paper matters, especially when you're using fountain pens and you want your inks to perform as best as possible. I have used fine and extra fine fountain pens on this paper, and it does okay. It does a decent job. I still have one of these notebooks in a different style that I'm trying to use up for morning pages, and I still use my fountain pens in that just fine. But if I'm trying to take it to the next level, if I really want to make the most out of my writing experience, I feel like this paper quality is best suited for ballpoint pens, emulsion inks, and gel pens. Fine liners, it's kind of pushing it. It really depends on the color and the brand, how inky it is. But because I'm now reaching for my fountain pens the majority of the time, I need to up my paper quality and have to say goodbye to these notebooks. Now, this might not be as spicy as the past two breakups, but it is something that I mentioned in one of my more recent videos where I tried your favorite fountain pen inks. And if you want to see that video, I'll have it linked in the cards and in the description box below. It needs to be said. It needs to be addressed, though, however unspicy it may seem. And it is the fact that I cannot with these blue ink cartridges. I don't even have words for these. It's great. Don't get me wrong. I think when you're buying a fountain pen, especially when you're first starting out, it's nice. It's a nice gesture to have an ink cartridge already there so that you can enjoy your fountain pen as immediately as possible. Let's break through the friction. Let's reduce the gap, right? I think it's important to make fountain pens as entry level as possible. But once you've tried one of these, what else is there? I don't know. Like, I'm probably gonna upset a lot of people by saying this, but I just feel like, what's the point? What's the point in including that blue ink cartridge? And I can't remember what video it was, but a pen friend was kind enough to take the time to explain to me that these blue inks are really great for completing legal documents. And for that reason, thumbs up, like that totally makes sense to me. And I have to sort of like rein in my irritation with the blue inks because it's practical. For me personally, and again, disclaimer, this is my own opinion based on my own experience and where I am at this time in my fountain pen journey. I just feel like there are so many inks out there to try. And from your suggestions that you left on my video where I was trying your inks that you've shared with me, that is very evident that I have a lot of inky goodness to experience. And if I'm gonna do that, then I can't waste my time with these little blue ink cartridges. So there's that. I would love to hear from you. Have you broken up with any stationery recently? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it with a pen friend who you think might also enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe and to turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss any of our videos. I do my best to upload here every Wednesday at 8 a.m. PST, so please take care until then. Feel free to enjoy these two videos linked here on the screen. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.
Mm-hmm.